Please sit down. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, that is how to make an entrance. Brilliant, well done, thank you so much. And I can't tell you how pleased we are to welcome you to your cathedral and this celebration of the Henry Beaufort School in your 50th year. We are so pleased that you have chosen to come and gather in your cathedral. Welcome to you all and congratulations. A very warm welcome to your head teacher, Miss Hurl, and to your chair of governors, Mrs. Wilson. A very warm welcome to all the present pupils, all the past pupils, all the present staff and past staff, their friends, and everyone associated with the school. Welcome, and we do hope that you will enjoy this act of worship and this time together in the cathedral. And also, I mustn't forget to welcome our preacher, Bishop David, who you know, and we look, spontaneous applause. So you've got one fan. We look forward to his message very much. Oh, I can see lots of people I know. It's lovely to see you out there. And it's been a long time coming, hasn't it? All getting together and doing something lovely together. So we're going to really enjoy this.
Allmächtiger, ewiger Gott, wir danken Ihnen für das Geschenk der Ausbildung in jeder Form.
Seigneur, je viens vers toi aujourd'hui pour te demander sagesse, connaissance et compréhension pour m'aider à suivre le chemin dans la poursuite de ma réussite académique.
Tien fu wa, rang wo chen wei, xue xiao shan yao de guang mang, wo yao zuo, nin jin yi dai de bang yang.
Bendiga a mis maestros, llenelos de sabiduría y sus labios con palabras para compartir con nosotros diariamente.
Chapter 1, Pride, from Psalm 34. I will praise the Lord at all times. I will constantly speak his praises. I will boast only in the Lord. Let all who are helpless take heart. Come, let us tell of the Lord's greatness. Let us exalt his name together. I prayed to the Lord, and he answered me. He freed me from all my fears. Those who look to him for help will be radiant with joy. No shadow of shame will darken their faces. In my desperation, I prayed, and the Lord listened. He saved me from all my troubles. For the angel of the Lord is a guard. He surrounds and defends all who fear him.
Thank you. found at the Henry Beaufort School.
To me it means I'm proud when I work hard.
I think it's proud of the people that we have met, our friends, and the reputation of the school.
I think it's about being proud to be a small part of something really special.
Friends, it's time for us all to join in. Please will you stand as we get ready to sing. Now, it may be some time since some of you have sung, and many of you may not have sung in this wonderful place, but you have to be very loud to fill the cathedral. So we're looking forward to hearing your singing today. My friend Mark is going to be helping leading us in our songs, but we've chosen songs which we hope that many of you will remember. Some of you not very long ago in primary school, some of you a little bit longer ago in primary school. So, we've just had a very nice school in who sung quite well. As they drive home on the motorways of Hampshire, let them hear you sing even louder and raise the roof. The first hymn is When I Needed a Neighbour.
Chapter 2, Happiness, from Psalm 144. I will sing a new song to you, my God. On the 10-stringed lyre, I will make music to you.
to the one who gives victory to kings, who delivers his servant David. From the deadly sword deliver me, rescue me from the hands of those whose mouths are full of lies, whose right hands are deceitful. Then our sons and our daughters, in their youth will be like well-nurtured plants, and our daughters will be like pillars carved to adorn a palace. Our barns will be filled with every kind of provision. Blessed is the people of whom this is true. Blessed is the people whose God is the Lord.
What does it mean to be happy at the Henry Beaufort School?
I'm happy when I come to school. I look forward to seeing my friends and the challenges that I have that day.
I feel happy when I'm in the lessons that I really enjoy. Usually those are the ones I'm good at, but sometimes I do well in those that I didn't think I was good at.
I'm happy that I can achieve what I want.
It's time to sing again, so will you please stand? One of my favourite songs, I Danced in the Morning When the World Was Begun. Let's sing nice and loudly and see if you can drown out Mark as he leads us.
They cut me down. Chapter 3, Ambition, 1 Timothy 6. Of course, there is great gain in godliness combined with contentment, for we brought nothing into the world so that we can take nothing out of it. But if we have food and clothing, we will be content with these. But those who want to be rich fall into temptation and are trapped by many senseless and harmful desires that plunge people into ruin and destruction. For the love of money is the root of all kinds of evil, and in their eagerness to be rich, some have wandered away from the faith and pierced themselves with many pains. But as for you, shun all this, pursue righteousness, godliness, faith, love, endurance, gentleness. Fight the good fight of the faith, take hold of the eternal life to which you were called, and for which you made good confession in the presence of many witnesses.
What does it mean to be ambitious at the Henry Beaufort School?
I know what I want to do in the future. It's going to be hard to get there, but school will get me there.
I don't know what I want to do in the future, but I know that I'm not limited by Henry Beaufort. In fact, I now want to know more than ever.
There is no limit to what we can achieve.
Beaufort, you are singing marvellously. We're going to stand again. This is one to really let yourself go, especially in the chorus. I can see some of you slightly coy teenagers are beginning to enjoy yourselves. So now's the time to let rip as we sing Shine, Jesus, Shine.
Jesus, Lord. Lord, may I speak in your name, and may our ears be open to hear and our hearts soft towards you. Amen. Do please sit. On Monday this week, I organised a funeral for a man called Bill. Bill had 8 children and was a retained fireman in Sutton Scotney. He died at 91 years old. But knowing I was coming today, the moment his daughter told me that she was one of the first pupils at Henry Beaufort in 1971, my ears pricked up. And I've been thinking about it ever since. What does it mean to have been open for over 50 years? We reckon at least 10,000 pupils have been through the doors of Henry Beaufort. 10,000. And on a 50th anniversary, you might have thought we'd have reeled out the names of 50 or 60 famous people who'd been through the doors of Henry Beaufort. But thank God we haven't. Because Henry Beaufort always has been and always will be about all of us. Founded with the latest educational principles as the first comprehensive school in the city of Winchester. And each successive senior leadership team, including the latest, has sought to put Henry Beaufort at the very front of educational thought and practice. You need to be proud, not just of yourselves because of your own creativity and your imagination in one of those themes of today, but I think rightly proud. Can I tell you a secret? I think you're the best school in Winchester. Not to be repeated outside of this church, is that all right? I've been involved for 21 years in Henry Beaufort, on and off. Times of great happiness and celebration. My children came to study music out of hours in the school premises. Always a hospitable welcome from successive heads as I've been involved in the school. But poignant for me, in 2014, a young lad called Mac was killed in a road traffic accident on his way into school on his moped. It was, in some ways, one of the bleakest moments in the history of the school. And yet the way none of you were there now, but the way some of the staff were, but the way the pupils learnt how to grieve together for a very popular young lad who died very prematurely was for me a mark of the real stature of Henry Beaufort School. Because we measure the strength of a school by how we cope with the very toughest days in our life. The days when it doesn't all go well. When friendship and companionship and the encouragement of our people around us mean everything. And you have that as a school all the way through your community. As indeed, I think there are some original 1971 pupils sitting in our midst, by the way. So we're talking here about 50 years. Here's the scary thing. Some of you can come back for the centenary. Not me. But I do think the clock stops still at a centenary. Sorry, it's a 50th anniversary. The clock stops still for a moment, and we try just to catch glimpses of what has shaped us over the last 50 years, and as the film so eloquently described, what the next 50 will also hold. But the values that underpin our gathering together, the fact that every pupil matters, the fact there's a strong sense of pupil-led learning. What is it that inspires you? What is it that catches your imagination? What is it that builds your creativity? What is it that helps you learn to depend on other people and so shape you for all the ambitions of the future? so shape you for what it means to live a life of contentment and even happiness. What it is to be able to say, I'm proud of the people I've travelled alongside. There is in this cathedral church, there are 800 letters on the back of boards at the back, where there are 800 statements that every pupil has written about what it is about Henry Beaufort that matters the most. And the one that my attention was drawn to was the one that said, I'm so grateful for Henry Beaufort because I'm safe away from the war. One of the beautiful seven from Ukraine, who's now part of your number. To offer hospitality to the stranger, to welcome those who are temporarily having to live in a different place, is in my mind also a mark of greatness. Because it's always how we treat those who are vulnerable that tells you the quality of a school, of a city, and I want to dare to say, of a nation. How do we treat those who are the most vulnerable in our midst? And that's why I think Henry Beaufort is the best school in the city of Winchester. Not because of the accolades, although there are many, not because of your teaching staff who are at the top of their profession, not because of the amazing pupils that you're sitting amongst, for you are amazing, but because every person matters. I want to end, if I may, with a verse from the Old Testament, a scripture that's held in high esteem by the Christian faith, the Muslim faith, and the Jewish faith. It's a conversation between a human being and God. And the conversation goes something like this: what is it that you require of me? And the voice of God comes back: love justice, show mercy, and walk humbly with your God. Love justice, show mercy to each other. Not a soft thing, a very strong thing. Forgiveness, reconciliation, provision. Walk humbly with your God. And because you're sitting in a cathedral church, whether you have a convinced faith, whether you're inquiring about what it's all about, or whether you have a different faith to the one represented here, I want to encourage you to always look for resources that are beyond yourself. For that's what it means to walk humbly with your God. Congratulations on 50 years. I don't think I'm going to make the centenary. I would be 111. But I will try. Amen.
Heavenly Father, we pray for all the students who have been educated at the Henry Beaufort School in the last 50 years. For all staff and students in our primary catchment schools. For all staff and students in our partnership schools. We pray for all former teachers and students, and especially for Mr. Hubert, founding head teacher of the school. Lord God, we give you thanks for our school and all who work and learn through our community.
We pray that all who are involved in our school will use their skill wisely, feel themselves to be valued, and that we will all learn and grow as part of our community. We remember all these people in their various tasks. Give them strength, courage, and a sense of purpose in their work. Lord God, we give you thanks for our school and all who work and learn through our community.
Lord God, we ask you to guide our school community and all who work in and support our community. We pray our school will continue to be a place of great discovery, adventure, and creativity. Lord God, we give you thanks for our school and all who work and learn through our community.
We pray for people training to be teachers and people considering a career in education. Help us to be aware of the needs of those who have the responsibility for educating others. May our community continue to support and care for others, remembering those in our community who might be struggling and reaching out for help. Lord God, we give you thanks for our school and all who work and learn through our community.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for every child and young person attending nurseries, primary and secondary schools, academies, colleges, and any other educational institutions. Inspire and energize them to make the most of the opportunities that they have to be diligent students, to play creatively, and to know that you delight in them as they seek to follow you. We bring these prayers to you in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Saviour. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Thank you all very much indeed. It has been a real joy singing with you. Thank you so much for joining in with such enthusiasm. This is our last song together. It's another favourite from the past, I hope, for many of you. Give me oil in my lamp, keep me burning. I hope it's not the last time you choose to sing in Winchester Cathedral, and we'll see you again for a service during the week, or at Christmas, or at some time soon. Let's stand up and sing loudly together. Give me oil in my lamp, keep me burning.
Give me oil in my lamp, I pray.
So a final blessing for each one of you and for your school. May God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the source of all goodness and growth, pour his blessing upon all things created and upon you, his children, that you may use his gifts to his glory and the welfare of all peoples, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.
And I know your headmistress, Agatha Trunchbull. I've been telling her all about you. Scary woman she is. Used to compete in the Olympics, throwing the hammer. Imagine what she'll do to a horrible little goblin like you, boy.
I'm a girl.
Now get off to bed, you bookworm.
That's a library book.
You showed the little brat. Oh, I'm late for my dance lesson with Rudolfo.
Now get out of here, you stinkworm.
Matilda, what a pleasure to see you here in the library again.
Well, my mum wanted me to stay home with her, but I think it's good for grown-ups to have their own space sometimes.
Your parents must be so proud to have a girl as clever as you. And do you tell them stories like you tell me? Oh, I love your stories, Matilda. That's a hint, by the way.
Once upon a time...
Matilda Wormwood! Where is Matilda Wormwood?
Yes, Miss Trunchbull?
Aha!
So you admit it, do you?
Admit what, Miss Trunchbull?
This morning, this foul carbuncle sneaked like a serpent into the kitchen and stole a piece of my private chocolate cake from my tea tray.
No, I did not!
Miss Trunchbull, Matilda's been here all morning.
Standing up for the little spitball, are you? Well, this crime took place before school hours, and therefore she is guilty. What are you doing with those books, woman?
They're for Matilda.
Not on my watch. There's an age for reading, and an age for being a filthy little toad. These are toads, aren't you, Bogtrotter?
Yes, Miss Trunchbull. Only Bogtrotter here is now a good toad.
Miss Honey, you believe in kindness and fluffiness and books and stories. That That is not teaching. To teach a child, we must first break the child. Quiet, you maggots!
Thank you. Thank you.